Hello students, we'll see what is the concept behind oogenesis. So first of all, what is oogenesis? Oogenesis is defined as a process of development and maturation of ovarian follicles and development of oocytes to ultimately give an ovum that will be fertilized by the sperm and produce a diploid zygote. So what is the purpose of oogenesis? Oogenesis is very, very important to continue the progeny. Imagine if there was no oogenesis, there would be no development of ovarian follicles, there would be no production of ovum, then whom would the sperm fertilize and how would the new life begin? So therefore oogenesis is very important. So before understanding oogenesis, we will need to understand what is the structure of ovary, because everything, all this oogenesis takes place inside the ovary. So the structure of ovary is divided into four layers. The outermost layer is called germinal epithelium, which is made up of epithelial cells. The inner layer, the next to germinal epithelium, is called tunica albuginea, which is again made up of connective tissue. And then in the middle of the ovary, there is ovarian medulla, which consists of connective tissue, blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves. And finally, surrounding the ovarian medulla, there is ovarian cortex. Now, why I have highlighted this cortex is because the development of different ovarian follicles, the development of primary oocyte to secondary oocyte, and then production of ovum from the secondary oocyte, all this takes place in the ovarian cortex. So let us see what are the different stages of oogenesis. So initially, even before the girl is born, inside the mother's womb, in the fetal stage itself, the primordial germ cells from the yolk sac, go to the ovary. Or once they reach the ovary, they start dividing mitotically and produce millions of germ cells. Now, these millions of germ cells are nothing but primary oocytes, and about 2 lakh to 20 lakhs of primary oocytes are produced. Out of these, only 40,000 remain until puberty, means others are just vanished from the female reproductive tract. And out of these 40,000, only 400 reach the stage of maturity and ovulate during the female reproductive lifetime, that is from the puberty to the menopause. So come back, what happened till now is, in the fetal stage itself, the primordial germ cells from the yolk sac reach the ovary of the fetus. In the ovary of the fetus, they started dividing mitotically to produce millions of germ cells. Now these millions of germ cells are primary oocytes, means they got differentiated into primary oocytes, and this primary oocyte started entering meiosis 1. Now primary oocyte was subjected to meiosis 1, but this meiosis 1 was not completed. Only prophase 1 of meiosis 1 occurred in the fetal stage, that is before puberty. So until puberty, only this much development takes place. After and until puberty, this primary oocyte is surrounded by a single layer of follicular cells, and together this primary oocyte and single layer of follicular cells together is called as primordial follicle. So did you understand what was the development that took place? The germ cells first got mitotically divided and produced many germ cells, and those many germ cells entered meiosis 1. They entered meiosis 1, but this meiosis 1 was not completed. Only prophase 1 of meiosis 1 took place. And what was this follicle called? Primordial follicle. What it consisted of? Only primary oocyte and a single layer of follicular cells. You can see on the right side, the picture above is of primordial follicle. You can see what it consists of. Now after puberty, this primordial follicle will start developing into a primary follicle. Now how this takes place? What do you mean by developing? There should be some additions of layers or some changes in the layers, and then there will be development of primordial follicle into primary follicle. So you can see what happens is the single layer of follicular cells will mitotically divide and produce several layers of granulosa cells. So once the single layer will change into several layer, the follicular layer will now be called as granulosa layer. Okay, so in the primary follicle, there will be primary oocyte surrounded by a several layers of granulosa cells. These granulosa cells rest over a basement membrane, and surrounding the basement membrane there is a layer of stromal cells. Now let me tell you, between the primary oocyte and between the layers of granulosa cell, a single layer of glycoprotein develops, which is called as zona pellucida. So this is a primary follicle. From the innermost, let us revise what it consists of. It consists of first primary oocyte. It is surrounded by zona pellucida, which is a glycoprotein layer. Then that is surrounded by several layer of granulosa cells. Those granulosa cells are surrounded by basement membrane. Basement membrane is finally surrounded by stromal cells. This is primary follicle. Now let us see how primary follicle gets developed into secondary follicle. So what happens is, the first change that takes place, do you remember the stromal cells, the outermost layer of the primary follicle? Now that gets developed into an organized layer called theca folliculi, and then the theca folliculi divides into two layers called theca interna and theca externa. Theca interna is the inner layer, which is vascularized and is responsible for secretion of estrogens, and theca externa is the outermost layer consisting of connective tissue and collagen fibers. The second change that takes place is, the granulosa cells, which were there in several layers, they start secreting follicular fluid, and this follicular fluid starts getting accumulated or deposited in a cavity called antrum. This cavity is present in the center of the secondary follicle. And the third change that takes place is, the innermost layer of granulosa cells get firmly attached to zona pellucida, and together they are called as corona radiata. So this was the development of primary follicle to secondary follicle. Let us see in this diagram. See, on the left side you can see the secondary follicle. Now what does it consist of? Initially it consists of, in the centermost or the innermost, it consists of primary oocyte. That is surrounded by zona pellucida. That is surrounded by several layers of granulosa cells. That is surrounded by basement membrane. And then there is theca folliculi, which has divided into theca interna and theca externa. You can also see a cavity that is developing called antrum, where the follicular fluid secreted by the granulosa cells will start accumulating. Also, so this is a secondary follicle. Now, the secondary follicle develops and ultimately reaches the maturity, and that follicle will be called as mature Graafian follicle. So let me tell you, out of so many cells that undergo development, only one follicle reaches the stage of maturity. So only there will be only one mature Graafian follicle at one time. So just before the ovulation, this inside these mature Graafian follicle, the primary oocyte completes meiosis 1. Means, wo jo prophase 1 that was initiated, you remember the prophase 1 which was initiated before the puberty, that meiosis 1 is continued now, and the metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1 get completed now, and finally the primary oocyte will give two haploid cells called secondary oocyte and first polar body. The smaller cell is called as first polar body, and the bigger haploid cell is called secondary oocyte. So now there are two cells inside the mature Graafian follicle. Also, there is, you can see in this, inside the mature Graafian follicle, there is something called as corona radiata. So what happens is, the innermost layer of granulosa cells get firmly attached to zona pellucida, and together they are called as corona radiata. So before rupturing of mature Graafian follicle, these things take place. One is, the primary oocyte, which is diploid, gives rise to two haploid cells. That is secondary oocyte and first polar body. Also, corona radiata gets developed by firm attachment of innermost granulosa cells to the zona pellucida. Again, before rupturing of this mature Graafian follicle, what happens is, the secondary oocyte, the haploid cell which we have obtained by the meiosis 1 of primary oocyte, enters meiosis 2. Meiosis 2 again has four phases, that is prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2. So secondary oocyte enters meiosis 2, and prophase 2 and metaphase 2 get completed before the rupturing of mature Graafian follicle. After that mature Graafian follicle ruptures and releases secondary oocyte, first polar body and corona radiata in the pelvic cavity. This is nothing but called as ovulation. Now, once the secondary oocyte is released, the meiosis 2 resumes only if there is sperm inside the female reproductive tract. If there is no sperm in the female reproductive tract, the released secondary oocyte, the first polar body and the corona radiata all vanish and the endometrium slugs off, which is nothing but called as menstruation. But if there is sperm inside the female reproductive tract, the meiosis 2 of secondary oocyte gets completed, that is anaphase 2 and telophase 2 will take place, and the secondary oocyte will further give two haploid cells, and of these two haploid cells, the bigger one is called ovum or egg and the smaller one is now called a second polar body. Once the ovum or egg is ready, the nuclei of the sperm will fuse with the nuclei of the ovum and ultimately give a diploid zygote. So this is oogenesis and this is how fertilization takes place. We'll quickly revise what had happened. So before puberty, there was primary oocyte arised from millions of germ cells. That is primordial germ cells. So these primary oocytes mitotically got divided and produced many primary oocytes, and before puberty there was only primary oocyte surrounded by a single layer of follicular cells, and together this was called as primordial follicle. This was before puberty. Look at the diagram in the left. Before puberty, this much development had taken place, but after puberty what happens is this primordial follicle gets developed into primary follicle. Now how does that take place? There is development of a single follicular layer into several layers of granulosa cells. There is also a development of glycoprotein layer called zona pellucida between primary oocyte and granulosa cells. There is also basement membrane, and then there was layer of stromal cells. Then the primary follicle gets developed into secondary follicle. Now how this takes place is, there is development of theca folliculi. The outermost layer of stromal cells is called gets organized. The outermost stromal cells get organized into a layer called theca folliculi. And then this theca folliculi gets divided into theca interna and theca externa. Also, the granulosa cells start secreting follicular fluid, which develops in the cavity in the center, and that cavity is called as antrum. And the third change that took place is the innermost layer of granulosa cells get firmly attached to the zona pellucida, and together they are called as corona radiata. So this was the development of primary follicle to secondary follicle. The secondary follicle grows and reaches the stage of maturity, and then it will be called as mature Graafian follicle. So mature Graafian follicle consists of primary oocyte, corona radiata, antrum, granulosa cells, basement membrane, and theca interna and theca externa. Finally, what takes place is, before ovulation, this secondary oocyte completes meiosis 2. That is, prophase 1 was started before puberty, but metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1 is still remaining, and that occurs in the mature Graafian follicle, and meiosis 1 is completed, and hence the primary oocyte will give one larger haploid cell which will be called as secondary oocyte, and one smaller haploid cell which will be called as first polar body. Then inside the mature Graafian follicle itself, this secondary oocyte will enter meiosis 2, and of the four phases of meiosis 2, that is prophase 1, anaphase 1, metaphase, anaphase 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2, only prophase and metaphase will occur, and then the mature Graafian follicle will rupture and release secondary oocyte, first polar body and corona radiata in the pelvic cavity. Then if there is sperm in the female reproductive tract, the secondary oocyte will complete meiosis 2, that is anaphase 2 and telophase 2, and it will give second polar body, that is smaller cell, and ovum, which is bigger cell. Both are haploid. The ovum will be fertilized by sperm and ultimately give a diploid zygote. So this is oogenesis. Listen to this lecture and read the notes, and if there is any doubt, you can message or call me anytime. Thank you.